students, welcome to the class of editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding Japan and quake preparedness written by Hiroaki Takahashi. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 1, paper 2, paper 3, plus this is very important for geography optional students. Now as far as this editorial is concerned, I will be discussing it from two perspectives. First of all, I will be discussing about the disaster and disaster management. Then I will be discussing about the disaster management organizational structure in India. So what is a disaster? Disaster generally are of two types. Disasters are of two types. There is a man-made disaster, then we have got the nature's disaster, natural disaster. Now as far as earthquake is concerned, it is a natural disaster. It is a nature's agony. It is a nature's way of spewing up its anger. Now, how can we manage this disaster? Now, in order to understand the management aspect of disaster, first of all, we must know about what is caused by this disaster. Why we call it as a disaster? Whenever a normal life is thrown out of gear, whenever there is a loss of property, whenever there is a loss of human life, whenever there is a loss of infrastructure, whenever there is a loss of human, now all these things collectively are called as disaster. Now, when a disaster takes place, we need to bring in the normalcy. We need to bring in the what was existing in the past. We need to bring in the old that has been shattered. We need to reinvent. So as far as the disaster management is concerned, it involves first of all preparedness. This aspect, we must be fully prepared for the disaster to take place. We must be prepared in terms of managing the emergency. We must be prepared in terms of mitigating the disaster that has taken place. We must be prepared for the rehabilitation. We must be prepared for resettling the people who have been affected by this menace of disaster. So it basically involves mitigation, it involves rehabilitation, it involves resettlement, it involves early warning signs so that at a pace action could be taken. Because whenever a disaster strikes, it strikes with a lot of pace, and if we want to mitigate its after effects, we need to tackle it with pace. So how can we make ourselves prepared, and what has been done in India to tackle the various type of disasters that takes place in India? Now as far as India is concerned, it faces n number of disasters, natural and man-made disasters. Now like the cyclone is there, then there is about the tsunami, then there is about the avalanches, then there is about the floods, then there is about the drought, then there is about the earthquakes, then there is about the landslides. So we have n number of man-made and natural disasters. And the biggest problem that is caused by the disaster is by the geological disasters, that is in the form of earthquakes. Other type of disasters like the meteorological disaster, they can be managed because the scale of the destruction that is caused when we do the comparative analysis of the geological disasters and the climatological disasters, the geological disasters, they are really havoc with respect to the meteorological disasters. Now, as far as India is concerned, we have created up our legislation. There is an act, National Disaster Management Act, NDMA. Now, under this NDMA, we have created various types of institutions and authorities, sub authorities, to prepare about the disaster, to prepare about the mitigation, to prepare about the rehabilitation, to prepare about the resettlement, so that the agony that is caused is less and less. So we have under this, the National Disaster Management Authority is there under NDMA Act, National Disaster Management Act, then we have a National Disaster Management Authority, then we have got State Disaster Management Authority, then we have the District Disaster Management Authority, then we have got National Institute of Disaster Management, then we have got ND, National Disaster Response Force. So this is a kind of institutional and organizational response that India has for the disaster, for the upcoming disasters. Now, as far as the organizational structure that we've created in order to manage this disaster, there is a lot of criticism for this. The criticism is that we have created this organizational structure that basically reflects the bureaucratic approach. We have created n number of organizations. There is less of coordination, there is less of cooperation. And because it being a highly bureaucratized organizational structure, like, there is no connectivity between the District Disaster Management Authority and the person who is heading this National Disaster Management Authority, that is the Prime Minister of India. So there is a lot of gap between the authority structures. There are n number of layers in between the top and the bottom. So this entire structure is not organic. This entire structure is hierarchical in nature. And because of the structure that we have evolved in India, it is also lacking in the involvement of the NGOs. NGOs ko involve nahi kiya gaya hai, civil society organizations ko involve nahi kiya gaya hai, panchayati raj institutions ka role bahut zyada kam hai. And the most important thing about the disaster management in India, it is the neglect of the people. Our entire approach is based on bureaucracy. It is not based on decentralization and democracy. And we tend to forget about the disasters that has taken place. We adopt the approach of procrastination and complacency. So disaster management is about being proactive. It is about being working at a pace. It is about involving n number of people, because the disaster that strikes, it causes big problems, and big problems can be tackled if you will involve good number of people. So involve more number of people, empower them, guide them, so that they can act as a force to fight against the nature's savagery, to fight against the nature's agony. It's the multiplicity of the number of the people that will help to fight. So we need to dilute the bureaucracy and the structure that we have in India. Only then we will be able to prepare it in a better manner. This is something that is reflected in the Japan's approach of how they have introduced legislations, of how they have infuse the science and technology in the architectural developments. that has helped them to mitigate the menace that may be caused in the future. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIAS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-940-0000 in case you are interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. You can check the details of the classes that we are offering at eiasmentors.com and at brainiki.com. You can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainiki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. For App Store, it is for the Apple users. And in case you like this video, please click on the like button and do share this video on your Facebook page, on your Facebook account, on your Google Plus account, and do comment on the video. And in case you have any sort of suggestions, you can WhatsApp me at my number 845-940-0000. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.